Hi guys, welcome back to another Sarah Speaks video. If this is the first time you're viewing any video on my channel, I'm Sarah Sarosh. I'm a 19-year-old medical student. I study occupational therapy and I also make beauty content on YouTube. So if you're new here, please don't forget to hit subscribe if you want to and wish to see my videos in the future. These are a series of videos where I just sit like chilled in my room and sit and talk to you guys. I have again gone AWOL on Instagram. I put up a post lately, like I think 3 days back. I'm gonna put it right here. The caption stated that I've been in unbearable pain in the past few days, and that's the reason I have been pushing myself to work. I don't call YouTube my work, but it is definitely work for me. When I get back home and I am always planning my content, it's very, very creatively satisfying. And very satisfying to a person like me. Y'all might not know me, but as a personality, I am very, very hyperactive. Like, the days I am sick, I can't bear to be sick because my mind is always hyperactive. Anyways, today's topic is not just about me, it's about everyone out there, and it's about how social media has been influencing and ruling our lives. I feel the reason I always go off Instagram and all other social media this time, the specific reason was that I suffer from a disease called fibromyalgia. It's a chronic pain disorder, and I got it about 3 years back when I was in my 12th standard. It was a post-traumatic stress disorder. Basically, every time there's a climate change, there's a stress change for me, a change in my routine, my health gets really effed up. I do take medicines for it, but the pain suddenly aggravates a lot. And since the third year has like just begun for me, third year medicine, the schedule just changed up. The climate is really bad at the moment, and all of that basically aggravated my pain. Despite all of that pain, I kept pushing through college and YouTube. I kept going to college every single day, no matter what, and I kept creating content in my brain and editing videos. But then I knew someday my body is going to give up, and that happened, and my muscles of the hand have become so weak that today I can't even hold a bottle of water. Last night I couldn't even hold my glass of milk. I am doing everything with my left hand, which is not a very dominant hand for me. I actually don't function at all with this hand. So it was a really bad phase, and everybody in my college, since I am studying therapy, my ma'am just told me one thing: Sarah, you need rest and you need to take a break. So that's what I did. I just uninstalled all possible social media on my phone, because that is a real rest. I think my phone, I don't want to say I'm addicted to my phone, because if you take away my phone and keep it, I will not go to it. I will not install an app again, or I will not take it, or I will not crave my phone. But when it's in my hand, I constantly check social media. I'm constantly doing something. Even if not social media, I constantly read books on Wattpad, I play games, and I'm constantly on my phone. So this requires a lot of thumb movement, and my fingers didn't have that much energy in them. So the first step, as soon as they told me, Sarah, you need to rest, I gave social media a rest. And that's when it got me to realize how much social media influences our lives. Like, I have a lot of friends, and I'm very blessed to have a really, really good, mashallah, really good set of friends. Like, they are always with me every step of the way. Like, I don't even need to name them, they already know who they are. They are with me constantly, my back, they are like my spine, you know. My muscles of my body are not that strong, but they are damn strong, and they are there for me. When I listen to stories from them, they are always like, haven't you all heard people say like, देख भाई सबकी शादी हो रही है हमारा ही कुछ नहीं हो रहा है सबका बॉयफ्रेंड है मेरा ही बॉयफ्रेंड नहीं है सब छुट्टियों पे जा रहे हैं हम छुट्टी पे नहीं जा रहे दिस सब हैज बिकम अ रीजन दिस द रीजन फॉर ऑल दिस कंप्लेंट्स इज इंस्टाग्राम एट द एंड ऑफ द डे नाउ आई एम नॉट अ वेरी स्नैपचैट पर्सन आई डोंट रियली स्नैपचैट एट ऑल आई डोंट पुट स्टोरीज I send Snapchat for streaks, which break really fast on my phone. But I'm very much an Instagram person. I really enjoy Instagram. I enjoy looking at people's posts. I enjoy keeping my profile up to date. And you definitely maintain a facade on Instagram. Like, you feel like telling the world that everything is okay with you, even when it's not. And I don't think anybody goes on Instagram when they're upset in their personal life. You will not see somebody fighting. Oh, I'm fighting with you, let's take a video and put it on Instagram. Oh, I'm so much in pain, let's take a video and put it on Instagram. Personally, I still try to keep it really, really real. Maybe if you've seen on my Instagram stories, I do share posts from fibromyalgia awareness pages. I do share my own story. Like if you can see, at the moment, I've just come back from my cupping therapy. If you can see these blood clots on my back, can you see this blood clots on my back? This is like all over my back. I don't want to instill any graphic images over here and scar y'all. But this is what I just got done with, like today in the evening. I went with my friend and got it done. It's called cupping therapy. You can Google it. It's called wet cupping. And you can Google and find out what are the benefits and everything. In chronic disorders like fibromyalgia, vertigo, migraine, any disorder which doesn't have a cure forever, these sort of alternative therapies do help. Now, I don't want to make this a very medical content related video, but I want to say that every person has some problem in their life. There's nobody who's perfect. There's nothing known as perfect. Nobody's perfect. If maybe sometimes I have encountered my friends whose life is fine, like if you look at them as a person, they are fine, but since they are so close to their families or they're so close to their friends, something in their friend's life or something in their family's life affects them. Like one of my closest friends, Ifra, she's like my childhood best friend, and she's been there. She's like, since I remember friendship, I remember her. She's been there since that time for me. And anything that happens in my life, looking at that also psychologically disturbs her. Like she's so attached and so close to me that she cannot see my pain, and that affects her. So everybody has some sort of psychological, mental, family issues, something or the other, and nobody wants to display that on Instagram. Nobody wants to display that on Snapchat. So we create such a facade that everybody, like suppose I'm at a low point in my life and I open Instagram and I see, I'm like, oh my god, this one's on vacation, oh my god, this one's enjoying their life so much and their life is so perfect, yeah, there's nothing wrong with it. It's not the case. It's never gonna be the case for anybody. I'm pretty sure people like Shah Rukh Khan and all the rich ones out there are also suffering in some way or the other. They definitely don't wanna tell us. People go into drugs, people go into so many other forms of trying to cope with their stress that they forget their stress. I know some people who have taken drug therapy as the alternative, like not the drugs which doctors give you, but the narcotics as a way to cope with the stresses that life has to offer. And I think that's the worst thing to do. You're going to torture yourself. Maybe not now. Now you won't feel it. And now those druggies always have one thing to say: who wants to live that long, or what is it? And you know, they have this thing, and if you meet a drug addict, they will just say that who wants to live that long, and it's about the now and it's about the present. And even I believe it's about the now and it's about the present. You don't even know if you live tomorrow, but you don't want to live in pain. 20 years down the line, you don't know what this is doing to your body. You'd rather talk it out. I always tell people, talk it out, you know, whatever is wrong with you. Today, I am sitting and talking to you guys in front of the camera. I'm in severe pain. This whatever I showed you is not easy for me because my fibromyalgia is a pain disorder and this creates more pain for me. So it's difficult for me to even talk to y'all, but I really want to. I really want to break the myth that nobody is perfect and nobody's life is perfectly happy. You can look at Instagram when you want inspiration. You know, I look at makeup related. I love makeup, like you guys know. Like even right now, I'm bare skinned and there's nothing, but I was just sitting bored and there's lipstick on my vanity. And I just sat and applied. I'm not gonna go anywhere, but I just sat and applied lipstick because it makes me feel better. So I will just check makeup related content on Instagram and on YouTube, and it makes me happy to see how people are so creative. If you are a travel junkie and in your life you travel a lot, it's good to see travel related posts. But if you're every time gonna sit and see a travel related post and be like, what a life, man, even I want such a life, it's good to work towards that life. It's not good to always curse your life, you know. Don't sit and curse every single living day of yours. That's not the way to live. I think that just keeps pushing you into a pit of depression and a pit of sadness where you just feel like your life is never good enough. Feel that you're good enough. Feel whatever you are right now, whatever your weight is, however your skin is, whatever your skin tone is, and whatever is going on in your life, it's fine. It is good enough. Don't feel that you are not good enough or this situation is not good enough. Family issues, everyone has them. Body issues, everyone has them. Some people like to talk it out. Some people just want to keep it within themselves. Sometimes when you ask your friends what is wrong with them, some people don't like intrusion, so you leave them be. But some people who you feel will keep it closed, but opening up will be the best thing for them, go. Push them and make them open up to you. Because y'all are not mind readers and your friends are not mind readers. So don't expect your friends to read your mind, and don't expect your problems to be solved just by sitting there, you know. Do something, distract your mind. Don't look at social media. If that affects you, don't look at it. Like, I personally, there was a time when I just deleted my account on Instagram. This was, I think, about 6 months back. Okay, since we're out here already talking about how social media influences us and how we take it in, I also want to talk about social media bullying. I feel like since the anonymity of social media, the anonymity social media and Instagram gives you, where when you're talking to somebody, you don't really know that person and you have that strength that you will never encounter that person. People feel like they are free to tell whatever they want. They don't realize the person at the other end does get really, really affected. Now, I for one reply to every comment, every single comment on YouTube and Instagram, and every single direct message as well on Instagram. There are YouTubers who don't reply, but that's because they get like 100,000 messages every single day. I'm pretty sure they do get that much. And even though they don't reply, I'm pretty sure they read everything you guys send. I feel like I barely have 2,500 subscribers and 2,000 Instagram followers. But still, the amount of people that give me hate is a lot in that also. And hate and constructive criticism are two different things, and the difference between them is very, very clear. When you say something, and I know in today's world, I will give you one clear-cut example, okay? I saw it that day and it was on a different YouTuber's Instagram. So she's an Indian makeup and beauty YouTuber, and she posted one photo, a fashion related photo, and she just posted it with a regular caption, and somebody asked, that bag is very pretty, where is the bag from? So she replied saying it's from so and so brand. Another person who was not at all in this conversation and not at all a part of this conversation commented saying she's replying because she's losing out on followers. You have no right to come out here on somebody else's Instagram and and it is her responsibility as a YouTuber to give out information. She didn't give it in a caption, so when somebody else asked her, she gave it as a reply. You didn't need to come and interfere and then say, oh, she's replying because she's losing out on followers. If she was concerned about followers, she would have already kept her profile up to date and everything. And I know this person, I don't know her personally, but I have been following her since a while. And I know she's been up and down on her content, but that's, you know, people asked her in that question answer session on Instagram, where have you been all this while? And her answer was healing. Like, she's healing away from social media. It's that much of a pressure in today's world, especially when you're out there posting content and making money off the content. That's your job for one. Anyway, that person says she's replying because she's losing out on followers, and this YouTuber replied saying, oh, how are you so smart? So she was trying to be sarcastic, and that's the way she comments anyway. Like, if you're an OG follower of hers, you'll know that she's that way. And then she replied back saying, don't get offended. And no, she replied back saying, I think this comment has been deleted. I remember very clearly she replied back saying, oh, what's with this filthy attitude and this sarcasm again? And these were the words she used, filthy attitude and sarcasm. This is the reason you're losing out on followers and blah and blah. And oh my God. And I was like, you didn't have to come out here and give your gyan. Uske upar you gave your gyan. And then later she commented saying, don't get offended. She said everything. She said your filthy attitude and sarcasm. And imagine reading that on your post for no reason at all, by somebody you don't even know. Anyway, she said, don't get offended, I'm sorry, I did not mean, this is not the YouTube one, that's the same person who commented saying, don't get offended, I'm sorry, I did not mean to hurt you or anything. It's just that you were being rude to your followers and I being one just told you that it was rude. Peace. Excuse me? Why did you have to come in between in the very first place? She was very nicely replying to her follower who asked her a question. And when you said that, you were the one being rude. So then she has all the right to be rude back to you. So she's not being rude to her followers. She was doing her duty. And you came out here as an anonymous person to give her your personal gyan. And not even gyan. First, so she was taunting. and then she's shouting, and then she's like, oh, peace. I'm not trying to be rude, you know, peace. Let's just keep the peace. I'm like, what? I was reading this as a passive person. I was really affected by those comments, and although it's not my post, but this is the... Imagine you getting a post like this and reading all this nonsense on your Instagram post. Won't that affect you psychologically? This is how much social media affects people, and people before commenting don't even think once, you know, like think. And if you have nothing nice to say, don't say anything at all. This is like a rule, a thumb rule you are taught when you're interacting with people. It's basic mannerism when you're talking to somebody. Maybe if you don't like something about this person and you're not so close to that person, will you tell them on the face that this is not nice about you? Will you be able to take back the response they give you? Only because you're anonymous on social media do you do that. If this person was right in front of me, or that YouTuber, should have never opened her mouth. This has happened to me once, like when the last time I deleted Instagram, there was a time when I just like deleted it forever, like for a week I just took off. And if you delete your profile on Instagram, nobody can search you and nobody can see your posts. When I did that, I was like taking a break from life. I just wanted to be in my zone and not interact with the real world, or just be with my friends and my family. And when I did that, when I came back, I had direct messages saying, oh, we missed you and stuff. But there were direct messages saying, where the hell were you and what are you doing and this and that. And there were like angry emojis, like, what's with the aggression? Chill down, I have a life outside Instagram. And whatever you see on Instagram is like 15 minutes of my day, 10 minutes of my day. I have 24 hours and I'm awake for 18 hours of that day, and I make the most of every single minute. So you don't even know what happens behind the scenes in my life, in your life. So many times I tell like my friends and family also, don't judge people based on what you see. Don't judge till they don't come and tell you what is wrong with their life, because you don't know how people are. I am a person who likes to voice out. You might not be a person who likes to voice out. Just because you're not telling your troubles doesn't mean they don't exist. So yeah, that's it for now. I just wanted to talk about in the social media aspect, how social media affects people. I know personally how it's been affecting me, how it's been affecting my friends, and how a lot of friends of mine have been going through a lot, and they've always like, everybody's so happy in their lives, Sarah, what are we doing with our lives? Or everybody's getting married, what are we doing with our lives? You're just 20, you're just 21, they are 30, they're getting married at 30, there's 10 more years to your life, and your full life is left ahead of you. So don't get influenced by social media, and whatever you are today, it's gonna be fine. Wherever you are is perfect. Whatever your weight is right now is perfect. Don't try to reach some goal weight, don't try to reach some goal skin. Nothing is goals. Goals are on the internet, they are photoshopped, they are face tuned, they are whatnot. So everything is a facade we create for Instagram and the social media world. Nobody wants to put out ugly pictures on Instagram, nobody wants to put out ugly graphics. Just remember when you see that everybody has a bad side and a good side, and they don't want to display their bad side doesn't mean it doesn't exist. That's all for now. I'm going to sign out. I'm very tired talking. All of my energy is drained out. I'm going to drink some water. You guys, I hope this helped you all. If you were going through a similar phase as me, something has been bothering you in your life, talk it out. You want to comment in the comment section as an anonymous person, you can. Y'all can email me and talk if you guys want to talk. I will reply to emails as well. If you want any sort of friend to talk to, I'm always there. I hope you guys all understand that whatever phase you are right now in life is fine. Y'all will get through it. If it's tough, y'all will get through it. If it's easy, then tough phases might come at you. Just be strong and don't get influenced by social media. It's a facade, it's a mask, and it's a good world, a good aesthetic world, but it's not all real. So remember that. I'm not going to say comment below, like this video, but do subscribe if you guys want to come back and view my content. I will see you in my next video, hopefully really, really soon, when I'm healed completely and in my happy phase again. I will come back to my makeup and beauty content. Until then, I will see you. Take care. Really, really take care. And I love you all so, 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 so much. Bye. So this will be all for now. For now, I'm gonna sign out. I hope you guys got the message I wanted to deliver out there. If you guys were in a similar phase as me and y'all also want somebody to talk to and y'all can't do it like me on YouTube, then email me if you want a friend to talk to. I will be there for you guys on my email. I will leave it here and in the description section. I will be able to help y'all better on email than on Instagram direct message, because I don't really reply personally one-on-one to Instagram direct message. So I can one-on-one talk to y'all on my email. I hope you guys all understand that whatever phase you are right now in life is fine. Y'all will get through it. If it's tough, y'all will get through it. If it's easy, then tough phases might come at you. Just be strong and don't get influenced by social media. It's a facade, it's a mask, and it's a good world, a good aesthetic world, but it's not all real. So remember that. I'm not going to say comment below, like this video, but do subscribe if you guys want to come back and view my content. Also ring the bell, click on that bell so that you know when I put out content there. I will see you in my next video, hopefully really, really soon, when I'm healed completely and in my happy phase again. I will come back to my makeup and beauty content. Until then, I will see you. Take care. Really, really take care. And I love you all so, 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 so much. Bye. Mm-hmm.